Today we're going to be looking at the LinkStation N1, a 6-bay All-SSD NAS by LinkPlus. Inside the box you get the LinkStation N1. Underneath that is a software license key and a user manual. And in the bottom compartment is a screwdriver and screws for the drives, as well as a 60-watt power adapter and a mains cable. Taking a look around the LinkStation N1, the top and sides don't have any ports on them. At the front we've got a power button and a power indicator. Beneath this flip-down cover is a single USB Type-C port and two SATA drive bays. There's also a row of network and drive activity LEDs above the USB-C port. Underneath this cover is an LED strip. At the back we've got a 3.5mm audio port, which is a bit of a strange addition for a NAS. Alongside it is an HDMI 2.0 port, then we've got two USB 3.2 Gen 2 ports, a 2.5GB Ethernet port, and a 12V power input. Underneath the ports are some ventilation holes for the internal fan. The bottom's aluminium and has two drive bay covers for the NVMe bays. Size-wise, being an all-SSD NAS, it is quite compact. It measures 21cm long, 15cm wide, and 3.5cm high, which they advertise as being the same footprint as an A5 sheet of paper. I quite like the look of this NAS. It looks like something you wouldn't mind having visible on a desk, rather than hidden away in a rack behind closed doors. The six drive bays are a little different to most NASs I've seen, which either have 2.5-inch SATA bays, or M.2 bays for NVMe drives. This NAS has a combination, with two 2.5-inch SATA drive bays that can be swapped out at the front, and then four M.2 bays for NVMe drives that are installed through the covers underneath it. Through these six bays you can install up to 48TB of storage. I guess technically you could use the SATA bays for mechanical drives if you want a cheaper storage capacity, but that would sort of defeat the object of an all-flash storage NAS. It's powered by an Intel N5105 CPU, which is a 4-core CPU running at 2GHz. While this means that it's not as powerful as a NAS like the F8 SSD Plus that I recently reviewed, it costs less than half the price. It's currently available for $399 from their website or from Amazon. It's got 14GB of DDR4 RAM and 128GB of flash storage. The RAM is soldered onto the motherboard, so it's non-removable, but it is the maximum that the CPU supports in any case. It's also got Bluetooth 5.2 and Wi-Fi 6, although we'll talk about the limitations of these a bit later when we look at the software. Now let's install some drives into it so we can test its performance. I'm populating the two 2.5-inch bays with Crucial BX500 drives, and the four M.2 bays with Crucial P3 Plus drives. These are just for testing. You should use NAS-grade drives if you're going to be using them in a NAS long term. The 2.5-inch drives are mounted into their trays using the included screws, and the trays then slide into place like traditional NAS drive bays. The M.2 bays are PCI Express Gen 3x1, so a fairly slow interface by today's standards. This is likely constrained by the CPU, but it would easily saturate the 2.5GB network connection. This is something to keep in mind though, as you could save money by going for older and slower drives without affecting overall performance. The bays only support 2280 size drives, and they have a toolless clasp that holds each drive in place. The covers also act as heat sinks for the drives, so there's a large thermal pad on each which you'll need to remove the protective film from before replacing the covers. Now we just need to plug in a network cable and power cable and press the power button to boot it up. Unlike a lot of NAS manufacturers, LinkPlus haven't tried to develop their own software for the N1, but they've rather shipped it out with an included Unraid license. I think this was a good choice. A product can have the greatest hardware and still be let down quite significantly by its software. We've seen this over and over with the SBCs that try and compete with the Raspberry Pi. Unraid has been around for a while and is a reputable software package for NAS setups. When you first boot it up, you need to enter the included Unraid license key to activate it, or you can run a trial of the software for 30 days before activating it. The Unraid installation is about as clean as it gets. LinkPlus haven't pre-configured anything or installed any supplementary applications. This is probably a pro for an experienced user, but maybe a con if you're new to Unraid and you're still finding your way around. You'll then need to assign your disks, start your array, and then create a network share. Unraid also allows you to install plugins, configure and run Docker containers, create and run virtual machines, and they have an app store with over 2,000 apps available to install to add functionality to your NAS. There are some downsides and limitations to Unraid in the N1. The standard version of Unraid supplied with the N1 doesn't support the available Wi-Fi and Bluetooth features, so you can't use either of these as part of the core NAS functionality. You can, however, use them through a virtual machine. The more significant issue is that Unraid's focused around physical mechanical storage drives and hasn't really been optimized to work with SSDs. There is a risk with some SSDs that they may do on-device data management, which would damage the parity data. Unraid's recommendation is to use SSDs as cache drives and then mechanical drives for the array. On the product page, they claim transfer speeds of up to 800 MB per second. This is likely referring to the maximum read speed that can be achieved from a single NVMe drive. While this is important in some respects, you're not going to get anywhere near the speed over a 2.5 GB network connection. You'd be lucky to get real-world results around 280 MB per second. You could potentially improve the network speed by adding a second 2.5 GB Ethernet adapter to one of the USB ports. This would allow you to take advantage of link aggregation, but this is just the limitation of the NAS to keep in mind. Most people aren't running more than 2.5 GB in their homes in any case. Testing transfer speeds, with a small 256 MB file, I get average writes of a little over 250 MB per second, and reads of a little under 270 MB per second. With a larger 1 GB file, I got average writes of a little under 250 MB per second, and reads a little under 260 MB per second. And with a very large 64 GB file, I get average writes of around 240 MB per second, and average reads a little over 250 MB per second. So quite consistent results across the three file sizes. Reads come fairly close to saturating the 2.5 GB network connection, and writes are just a little slower. I then tried running real-world file transfer tests in Windows 11, transferring a large 70 GB video file. Writing to the NAS, we get a very consistent write speed of a little over 280 MB per second. And reading from the NAS, we get a similarly consistent but slightly lower average transfer speed of about 255 MB per second. The LinkStation N1 is really quiet. It obviously doesn't have any mechanical drives in it, which eliminates drive noise. You can hear a fan running when it's on, but it is really quiet. I also couldn't hear or measure any difference between the fan noise at idle and when reading or writing to the drives. Under a full CPU load, the fan is a bit more audible, but it's still pretty quiet. You can't hear it from more than 2 meters away in a quiet room. Power consumption on the N1 is also great, using just 11 watts at idle, and this only goes up to around 17 to 18 watts when reading or writing to the drives. Overall, I think the LinkStation N1 is quite a nice entry-level all-flash storage NAS package. It has a well-balanced set of features, and although it's limited by the single 2.5 GB Ethernet connection, this is likely good enough for most home or small office use cases. I think their decision to include an Unraid license rather than developing their own software is a really good one, and you've obviously still got the flexibility to go with a different OS if you'd like to. Let me know what you think of the LinkStation N1 in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.